He served the dark and avenged the gods. What do you father of these? Straight!
Naive.
beautiful, a pious vulture of the law, with a gesture of his claw, removed the barber from his plate. Then there was nothing but to wait, and she would fall, so soft, so young, so lost, and oh, so beautiful. Somewhere I must go. Something I must do now. And alone.
Well, surely we will meet again before our uncle comes.
If you want to meet me, you may very well. Around Fleet Street, I wouldn't wonder.
Well, then. So long then, Mr. Todd.
There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and it's filled with people who are filled with shit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it.
Even harder than the worst wine, and that's not enough.
things than that down there.
Isn't that a room up there over the pie shop? The times are so hard, why don't you rent it out? That could bring in something.
Ah, no one will go near it. People think it's haunted. You see, years ago, something happened up there. Something not very nice. There was a farmer and his wife, and he was beautiful. A proper artist with a knife, but they transported him for life, and he was beautiful.
Transported, what was his crime?
Oh, he had his wife, you see. Pretty little thing, still a little thing, had a chance for the moon on a string. Oh, fame. There were these two, you see. One to the lad mad, one of them a judge, the other one is beat up. They'd nudge and they'd wean off, but she wouldn't budge from her needle. Too bad, cute thing. So they nearly shipped the pork like a rat, and they did, leaving her with nothing but grief and a dear old kid. Did she use a handy but then call the bank a bit? Poor fool, up and there was one yet to count for fame. It's a baby's name, pretty little Joanna.
Go on.
Ah, you do like a good story, don't you? Well, Beedle calls on her all polite. Hoping, the judge, he tells her is all contrite. He blames himself for a dreadful plight. She must come straight to his house tonight. Hoping. Goes there, poor thing, they're having this ball all in masks. There's no one she knows there, poor thing. She wanders tormented and drinks, poor thing. The judge has repented, she thinks, poor thing. Oh, where is Judge Turpin, she asks. He was there all night, only just so contrite. She wasn't no match for such craft, you see. And all of them thought it's a roll. They figured she had to be daft, you see. So all of them stood there and laughed, you see. Oh, no.
Return to a loving wife and child. Let them quake in their boots, Judge Turpin and the Beadle. For their hour has come.
You gonna get him? You will bleed little nobody of a runaway convict down, my Beadle. You'll never get his high and marginous, nor the Beadle, neither, never in a million years. Have you got any money? Listen to me, have you got any money?
No money.
Well, are you gonna live?
I'll live. If I have to sweat in the sewers and a plague hospital, I'll live and I'll have it.
Oh, you poor thing. Ah, you poor thing. Watch.
Oh, who knows? Maybe the whole bloke will be back someday and need them. Crap, in the end, what belongs? With times as bad as they are, I could have got 5, maybe 10 quid for them anyway. See, you can be a barber again.
Hungry as always, Mr. Anna. I'll steal you, Joanna.
even now I'm at your window. I am in the dark side. There is Sweeney in your yellow hair. I feel your hand, and one day I'll steal you. Shall I with you there? I'm with you there. Tomorrow they'll all be flocking to me like sheep to be sure.
Oh, there's the fatal bastard.
So much the better.
Yeah, but what if he recognizes you? Haven't you got...
I will do what I have set out to do, woman.
Oh, sorry, I'm sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, this may have your attention, please. Be awake every morning and shave in despair. The son of your pillow is coming to hair. Well, not to be there. Well, ladies and gentlemen, from now on you can wake it at ease. You need never again have a worry or care. I'll show you a miracle, marvelous rare. Gentlemen, you are about to see something that rose from the dead. On the top of my head. Scarcely a month ago, gentlemen, I was struck with a horrible dermatologic disease. From the finest physicians in London were called. One morning, amazed and appalled, to discover with joy that my head was as bald as a novice's knee. I've died of shame till a gentleman came, an illustrious barber, her rarely by name. Give me a liquid as precious as gold. I rubbed it in daily like what I was told. And behold, only 3 days old.
Right.
Don't you, Crowley? The man, he's the father of it. Lady, he's the father of it.
concocted from piss and ink.
Please, Lord. You better to throw your money down the sea one.
Ladies and gentlemen, pay no attention to this madman. Now, who's to be the
first? Furthermore, senor, I service no kinkies. And I wager that I can shave a cheek and pull a tooth with 10 times more dexterity than any street mountebank. You see these razors?
Are they stealing drink?
I lay them against 5 pounds. You are no match for me. You hear me, sir? Either accept my challenge or reveal yourself a shack.
These are indeed fine razors. Instruments like these, once seen, cannot be good or bad. And they find extractor, too. You wager these there against 5 pounds?
I do.
You fear this foolish man! Watch and see how he will regret his folly. 5 pounds, it is! Give it up!
£5.
Oh, yes. Dear sir, as may the good Lord favor you until we meet again. Come, boy. Signori, benissime signorine, buongiorno. Buongiorno a tutti!
Oh, he shut me down. Sweeney Todd's tonsorial parlor, right above my meat pie shop on 6th Street.
Mr. Todd! Straight. But it seems your face is known to me.
Him being my uncle's cousin, what arrived from Birmingham yesterday.
Yes, and yet already have I heard Beadle Bamford spoken of with great respect. Will I try my best for my neighbors? Fleet Street above your pie shop, man?
That's right, sir.
Then, Mr. Todd, you will surely see me there before the week is out. You will be welcome, Beadle Bamford. I guarantee to give you, without a penny's charge, the closest shave you have ever known.
Sweeney Todd and Sweeney Van, like a perfect machine, he man.
Barring the hook,
taking the trap,
setting it down for the Beadle to snap.
Why did Todd and Sweeney did?
Nothing else, though, it is.
she has a guardian so tyrannical, she is kept shut up from him and I. Now, this morning, this key fell from her shuttered window. The surest sign that Joanna loves me.
Joanna?
That's her name. Curtain, that's the abominable parrot. A judge, it seems, a monstrous tyrant. Oh, Mr. Todd, once the judge has gone to court, I slip into the house and plead with her to fly with me tonight. Yet when I have her, where can I bring her until I have hired a coach to speed us home? Mr. Todd, if I could lodge her here just for an hour or two.
Bring her here.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. I have your consent, Mrs. Todd.
The girl may come.
Oh, she'll be grateful for this to the grave, I'm afraid. Surely now, the time is up to the old bay. I thank a thousand blessings on you both.
Joanna, who'd have thought it? You'll have her back here before the week is out.
For a few hours. Before he carries her off to the other end of England.
Who, that fellow boy? Oh, let him bring her back here. Then since you're so hot for a little... That's the throat to sleep in. Oh, we'll make a lovely home for her, we will. Think of it all those years without a scrap of motherly affection. Well, I'll soon change all that, I will, because if ever there was a maternal heart here, it's mine. Look.
Good morning,
Miss
Todd. And for you, Bailey, prima signorina.
As it is, Signor, I'm sure.
A little business with Mr. Todd, Signora. Perhaps if you will give the permission.
Oh, yes, indeed. I'll just pop down to my car. Oh, looks, look at it now. Don't look like it's in the converse. It's our part now. Why don't you say something to a nice, juicy meat pie, eh?
Please, Mom.
Yeah, but tell me that.
Mr. Todd, Signor Fred.
Ah, no. Call me Johnny. Daniel O'Higgins is the name, when it's not professional. Well, now, it isn't very much, but I imagine you'll split it up a bit. I'd like to take £5 back, if you don't mind.
Why?
That's my boy,
Pat. It will hold me to the master of your home. That is half your profits you'll hand over to me every week on a Friday. Yes, very nice. All right. Mr. Benjamin Barker.
Why do you call me that?
Well, at least you got a nice house to get ahead there.
Well, to tell you the truth, Mum, it gets awful hot. You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just a down-and-out Irish lad to hire for a couple of weeks, sweeping a pen and such like. But I remember thee. And you. Benjamin Barker. Lay the transportes upon me, they, for life. So, Mr. Todd, is it a deal? Or do I run down the street from your pal, little mom? You figure you're smart, you foolish woman! Come on, you start! In my blood! You cannot stand! You lie for my blood!
Down there.
I'm sure that we know the fire. cup. Gentleman says to give me a nice cup of gin.
Gin, I don't want it.
No!
Your hand so quick, his fingers strong. He stung a little, but not for long.
And those with the simple blood were soon reconsidering under the sod.
Consigned there with the friendly prompt from Sweeney Todd. A demon father of Fleet Street.
See your razor gleam, Sweeney. Feel how well it feels.
How well it
bends, it floats across the throat of him.
Your persistent dedication to a life of crime is such an abomination before God and man that I have no alternative but to... Auditor. It is perhaps remiss of me to close the court already, but the stench of those miserable wretches in the bar is so offensive to my nostrils. I fear my eagerness for fresh air might well impair the soundness of my judgment.
Well, sir, you turn when you spoke to the meat, sir. For I'm meeting the day if we celebrate my little lady's birthday.
May our day end of blue darling finger. We have crying joy on such a happy day.
It is a happy moment for me, too.
Go up boldly, my friend. I have news for you. In order to shield her from the evils of this world, I have decided to marry Joanna next Monday.
Ah, sir, happy news indeed.
Strange, when I offered myself to her, she showed certain reluctance. That's only natural in a girl so young. No doubt now that she's had time for reflection, she'll greet my proposal in a more sensible frame of mind.
Even their genteel proclivities.
Double, you say? Well, perhaps at times I am a little over hasty in my morning evolution.
Fret not, oh my lord, I'm your lady, my lord, and dog, oh my lord. Still, put on you the shade of face, my lord, the moment it comes to break, my lord, and marks you in the hands of cheek, my lord, you'll dazzle the guarantee.
Yes.
She falls for your every will.
Yes, that may well be so.
Well, sir, here we are, sir. I bid you good day.
Good day. Oh, where is this miraculous barber?
In Fleet Street, sir.
Perhaps you're right. Take me to him.
Accomplished of all the barbers in the city.
That is very gracious of him, sir.
And as for my rooms, please excuse their modesty. I only moved in here a few days ago, and some necessaries are yet to come. Sit, sir. If you, sir, sit.
Isn't this nice and cozy? Sit, dear, sit. What's the matter, Archie? Well, you sit here like a good lad while I go into the locker and get us a new bottle.
And what can I do for you, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair? A soothing skin massage?
You see, sir, a man infatuated with the heart and be a slave. So fetch the pomade and pocket stone and lend me a more seductive tone. A string thing, perhaps a French cologne, but first the right thing. A shame.
The closest I ever
time, Joanna, elope with you, deceiving slut!
I suffer in some obscure retreat where neither you nor any other vile corrupting youth shall ever lay eyes again. What company you keep, will service them well and hold their custom, for you'll have none of mine out of my way. Everything's set. Out, I say, out!
All is running and shouting. What is it now, here?
I had him and then...
Oh, I know the sound of that thing. I saw them running down the street and I took them out the hall back. Things are seems an awful waste. That's a nice plump tray. What is my name? As? No, it can't be tray. Does it need a lift? That's to be erased. Think of it as script, as a gift. Have you got my drift? No? Seems an awful waste. Coming with a part of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it. Good, you got it. Using only pussy cat and toast. And a pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't come out as far as
Mrs. Robin, what a charming notion.
It's priest. Have a little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't come mixed in of the flesh. So it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only when it's fat.
Poet or something like that.
Now you see the trouble with how it is out and you know it's deceased. Try the priest.
Heavenly. Not as hearty as bishop, perhaps, but then not as bland as curate either.
Good for business, too. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it on Sundays. Lawyers rather nice.
If it's for a price.
Or there's something else, though, to borrow, since no one should swallow it twice.
Have you any dean?
No, but if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. Anyway, it's clean. No one wants it taste of wherever it's been.
Is that squire on the fire?
Rising up, sir, look closer, you'll notice it's grosser.
Looks thicker, more like thicker.
No, it has to be grosser, it's green.
The history of the world, my love.
I've a lot of grades to a lot of relatives' favors.
Is those below serving those up above?
Everybody shaves so there should be plenty of flavor.
How gratifying for once to know that those above the so good down below.
Now, let me see. We got Pam Tinker.
No. Something pink.
Taylor.
Taylor.
Butler.
Sutler.
Potter.
Paul.
Bounceman. Lovely bit of clock.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, the sweets if you want it cheap and you mark it dark. Sonic Lancia. Pink of his career.
That looks pretty rank.
One franc, so it's bad cashier. Like a new song. Wasn't quite so old.
Have you any Beagle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beagle isn't bad for your stomach. And notice how well it's been greased. Stick to priest. Now, this might be a bit tricky, but then, of course, it's a fiddle player.
No, no, this isn't fiddle player. It's piccolo player.
How can you tell?
It's piping hot.
Then blow on it first.
The history of the world, my sweet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, what does it tell?
Is who gets eaten at the
gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd, too, Mr. Todd, who gets the crown.
Fortunately, it's all so clear that everybody goes out well with beer.
Screamed up the field to you. How about Rear Admiral?
Too salty. I prefer a general.
With or without his privates.
What is that?
It's Fox, finest in the shop. Hand it up to Shepherd, five Packard with actual Shepherd on top. He's a politician, so warily, it's served with a dorney at once.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to run. And always a right overdone. I'll come again when you have judged on the men.
What? True, we don't have judge yet, but we do settle for the next best thing.
What is that?
Executioner.
More hot,
excuse me, dear. Think of the
up the stairs.
We have
to
stairs.
It's about to be over, don't you care? But we have to prepare.
Goodbye. I never hear your voice, my turtle dove, my dear. I still have reason to rejoice. The way ahead is clear, Joanna. And in that darkness when I fly with what I can forget, it's always morning in my mind, my little lamb, my pet, Joanna.
Let me see now, that's orange rabbits, 4 and 11 pence, that makes £7, 9 shillings and 4 pence. This week, not bad, eh? And that don't include what I paid out for this cheery new wallpaper and the harmonium. And it was a real bargain, dear. It'd been only partly singed when the chapel burned down. Mr. Todd, are you listening to me?
Of course.
Well, what did I say?
There must be a way to the judge.
Oh, bloody old judge. Always harping on the bloody old judge. Here we got a nice, respectable business going. Money coming in regular. And since we're careful to pick and choose changes and such like, what won't be missed? Who's going to catch on? Making those little castles in the sand. I could still feel me toes wiggling in the brine. By the sea, Mr. Todd, that's the life I carve it. By the sea, Mr. Todd, who I know you'd love it. You and me, Mr. T, we could be alone in a house what we'd almost own down by the sea.
Anything you say.
Would that be smashing? With the sea at our gate, we'll have to go. What was one to escape from the scrape of bearing every night in the kit. When we're through our kippers, I'll be there slipping off your slippers by the sea. With the fishy splashing by the sea. Would that be smashing down by the sea?
Anything you say.
The breakers breaking, the squeakers squawking. Ooh, ooh, I can be begging that I'll go walking with you. Ooh, ooh, I hold me from the Olympian day. A key and skirt with me gay and gray. Then you write a letter while I knit a sweater. Unless we know that that to do.
Anything you say.
Think of that, it'll be underneath our candle when it's just you and me and the English candle in that cozy retreat. Kept only that party, we'll have chums over every Friday. By the sea, that's the month of weather. By the sea, we'll come on together. In our baby dresses, you in a nice navy blue, and me in stripes, perhaps. It'll be so quiet that we'll come by it, ecstasy girl. We shouldn't try it, though chill it's legal for two. But the seaside wedding could be devised, me rumpled bedding, me chintin mice, me eyelids will flatter, I'll turn into butter. By the sea in our nest, we could share our tippers with the hot paying guests from the weekend trippers. Have a nice sunny suite for the guests to rest in. Now and then you could do the best in by the sea. Nice, nice and proper. By the sea, bring along your charter. happening. You do love me just a little bit, don't you?
Yes.
Well, then how about it? It would mean a visit to St. Swithin's to make it nice and proper. But that wouldn't be too painful, would it, dear?
I'll make them pay for what they did to Lucy.
Oh, now listen to me, dear. It's high time you forgot all their morbid fancies. You're Lucy's gone, poor thing. It's your Nelly now, isn't it, love? Here, have a nice bonbon. Here. I don't see why I shouldn't be married in white, do you? John!
Wait, I found her.
Joanna, you found her?
That monster of a judge has had her locked away in a madhouse.
Where?
Well, no one can reach her. At Todd's asylum. Oh, Mr. Todd, she's in there with those screeching, gibbering maniacs.
Joanna is as good as rest.
She is?
Where do you suppose all the wig makers in London go for their human hair?
Oh, couldn't say the more wiggly supply.
Bedlam. They get their hair from the lunatics at Bedlam.
Then you think...
Todd's asylum, why not? Right, for the right amount of money, they'll give you the hair off any madman's head.
Oh, well, I'll give you the scalp too, if you need excuse me, gentlemen.
Now, would you like a letter to this Mr. Fogg, offering him the highest price for hair, the exact shade of Joanna's, which I trust you know?
Yellow.
No, not exact enough. I've got to make you into a creditable wig maker quickly. There's tawny, and there's golden satin, there's flaxen, and there's blonde. Repeat that. Repeat it.
Yes, Mr. Fogg.
Well?
There's tawny,
there's coarse, there's fine, there's straight, there's curly, there's gray, there's white, there's black, there's curly, there's gray, there's yellow, there's black, there's
orange, or narrow. Sweeney waited too long before, but never again before.
Fortune was blind, Sweeney is dead, Sweeney was raining, Sweeney is gray.
Sweeney problems are not in smoke, all dissolved with a shame of smoke.
Sweeney was sharp, Sweeney was burning, Sweeney began, the end is turning, Sweeney was
but kill if you must.
I'll kill a dozen jailers if need be to set her free.
Then off with you all. Oh, Andy, wait, listen to me once again. Once you have rescued her, bring her here. I will guard her until you hire the chaise to Plymouth.
We'll be with you before the evening now.
Good.
Mr. Todd?
Yes.
Thank you, friend.
Yes.
Thank you.
now, Silas.
That's not all. Look, a lovely muffler. I guess who it's for.
Who, Mum? For me?
Which of us is yours? I love
you. He's so good to me, Mum. Sometimes, when I think of what it was like in Signor Perez, seems like the good Lord sent it for me.
Oh, it's just my warm heart, dear. Running up there for all of God's creatures.
You know, Mum, there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. If there was a monster, an ogre, or anything bad enough that was after you, I'd rip it apart with my bare fists, I would.
Oh, what a sweet child it is.
Even if it was just a man.
A man?
Man. Bad. What might be luring you, all unbeknownst, into his evil deeds, like...
What is this? What are you talking about?
Nothing's gonna harm you. Not while I'm around.
Of course not, dear. Why should it?
Nothing's gonna harm. No, sir. Not while I'm around.
What do you mean, a man?
Demons are prowling.
Thank you.
so obedient, so hardworking. No, I have always fancied coming to help him bake the pie.
Oh, yes, Mum, indeed, Mum, yes.
Well, I'll find it.
You mean it? I can help you make them and bake them?
But I don't have like the president. And the witch come up. Some old dear dark, God knows what's down there. Always a couple of rats gone home to Jesus.
Bring nothing.
Hardly big enough for all the parts we sell. 10 dozen at a time. Ooh. Now, be sure to close the oven door properly like this. Now, here's the grinder. That's an obsolete here. Grind it. Comes out down there. And you know the secret what makes the pie so sweet and tender? 3 times. You must put the meat through the grinder. 3 times. Yeah.
3 times, huh?
Right. Smoothly, smoothly. That's the one. Now the next batch of meat we get, we'll put you to work.
Ooh, me making pies all of me own.
We go back in a minute, dear.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Lovett. Fine instrument you require.
Oh, yes, it's my pride and joy.
Well, I hope you have some time this afternoon, Mrs. Lovett, for I'm here today on official business.
Official?
Yes, you see, there's been complaint.
Complaint?
Well, it's about the stink from your chimney. They say at night it's something foul, so health regulations being my duty, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to let me take a look.
At the boathouse?
That's it, Mum.
Oh, but it's locked, you see, and I don't have the key. Mr. Todd upstairs, he's got it. But he's not here right now.
When will he be there?
Oh, I couldn't say, I'm sure.
One of Mother's favourites. If one bell rings in the cover of grey, ding dong, your true love will stay. Ding dong, one bell day in
the cover of grey, ding dong.
Well, what's that? But surely he's in the bakehouse, then, isn't he?
Oh, no, yes, of course he is. But you see, he's a little bit darker, simple in the head. A couple of weeks, he ran off. We found him 2 days later down by the embankment. Half starved, poor thing. So, ever since then, he locks him in for his own security.
Well, we'll just have to wait for Mr. Talking. Click, two bells ring, or turn
music, Papa. Why not raise your voice along with mine?
Ding dong!
Ding dong!
Your true love will pray! Ding dong!
Ding dong!
Two bells today in the power of ray!
Ding dong! Ding dong!
Three bells ring in my
heart! Oh, I just remembered Mr. Todd. He went to Wapping. He won't be back for hours. Dear me, I'm so sorry to miss you. Only the other day he said, if only the beadle would grace my tonsorial parlour, I'd give him the most stylish haircut and the daintiest shave all for nothing. So why don't you drop by sometime when he's here and take advantage of his offer?
Well, that's real failure. If four bells ring and not half of them today.
How many bells are there?
Well. Ding dong.
Look at me. He wants the key. I told him you had it. Oh, but there's no worry, Mr. Dingleberry. Oh, why don't you run upstairs with Mr. Todd and let him fix you up all pretty nice? And I'll be time for the bake-out later.
Tell me, Mr. Todd, do you pomade the hair? I dearly love a pomaded head.
Pomade? Oh, yes, of course. And a nice facial rub with belly rum. All for free.
Seems like it's my lucky day. I take this very kindly, Mr. Todd.
I am, sir, entirely at your disposal.
Oh, I do hope he does it quietly. But to be on the safe side, I will provide a little musical accompaniment. Sweet voice, mountain, and love, rock.
The most black owl, probably.
Ooh, it's a fingernail.
Where's my cut, sir?
Anthony,
Where is it?
Oh,
Steve with her fancy gown and her fancy ebb and her...
Yes, dear! Devil's heart! Where are you, Nina? Nina!
Rats in the street!
I trust him as I trust my right arm.
Now, wait for him here, and I'll return with the coach in less than half an hour.
But they are after us, Phil. What if they should take us here? Please, let me go with you.
No, my darling, there is no safety for you on the street.
But just let me save us close. We'll know it's not.
No!
The risk is too great.
Miss, look at me, miss. Oh, look at me, please. Oh, baby. Favor me with your plans. Ah, miss, soon we'll be gone and sailing the seas and happily wed in France. And we'll sail the world and see its wonders.
Oh, no.
Before those lips have time to lose that smile.
Oh, sir, no doubt the years have changed me, but then perhaps
the face of a barber, the face of a prisoner in the dock is not particularly memorable.
Can it be? All the demons in our hearts are to torment me. Think of the oven with that quake.
Why do you scream?
It's just so soon.
It's just the oven that will be ready for now, Sweeney.
Now leave them to me, go.
No!
Open the door, I say.
No, no, come on.
What's the matter with you, woman? It's only a silly old baker.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. Don't, I know you, she said, don't. You knew she lived. From the first moment I came into your shop, you knew my Lucy lived.
Lucy. Your Lucy, a crazy hag, picking bones and little spots out of any asphalt. Would you want me to know she ended up like that?
You lied to me.
No, no, not lied at all. You were never lied. Said you suffered and cheated. Never said that she died. Coming, she lived for a little weekend. Her head was in it for my husband's ladder in bed. Should have been hustling for a while. I've been met a million. Coming, but you think she.
Practical and yet appropriate as always. As you said repeatedly, there's little point in dwelling on the past.
Do you mean it?
Everything
I thought was only for the best.
Fear, but
I'll
can't
tell you
the history of the world I pass.
Oh, Mr. Todd, leave it to me.
Is ask forgiveness and try to forget.
By the sea, Mr. Todd, where we can't become you. By the sea, Mr. Todd, where there's no one there.
But life is for the alive, my dear. So let's keep living it. Let's keep living it.
Thank you.
the track.
Me mistress, the alarm.